Welcome to VOS classes. In this series of lecture, today we are going to cover two topics. First, yellow dust. It's a yellow color dust. Dam rehabilitation and improvement project launched by Government of India in 2012. And Ophiocordyceps Newtons. And third one is a species that is fungi. And it's presented by me, Ravindra Maurya. In last class, that is CA2, we have covered three topics: olive ridley turtles, Ronco tortoise, and peacocks of shell turtles. Our today's topic is yellow dust. As the name suggests, is the yellow colored dust, and it was in news because it is capable to spread COVID-19 virus. And it originates from desert of China and Mongolia, from where coronavirus originated. It is the Wuhan, city of China, and it descends on Korean Peninsula. That is the region of South Korea and North Korea. These two are images taken from internet. How it look like? The second topic is dam rehabilitation and improvement project. There was news that India's majority of dam are having age of more than 25 years. That means they are very old. They need some kind of renovation, rehabilitation and improvement. In this view, the Government of India launched dam rehabilitation and improvement project in 2012. It was in news because phase 2 and 3 are going to implement it from April 2021 to March 2031, and it receives financial assistance from World Bank and AIIB, that is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Remember, India is the member and I can say founding member of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. It was launched by CWC in 2012. There are two components, that is the dharma and sizes. You need to remember only the acronyms of these two terms. Dharma stands for dam health and rehabilitation monitoring, and the SEISIS stands for seismic hazard analysis information system. These two are images taken from the internet. And the third and last topic for today is Ophiocordyceps Newtons. It is an entomopathogenic fungus, and it belongs to the order Hypocereal. It was in news because it's the first time that it was found in Central Asia and Central India, and previously it was reported in India only from Western Ghat. And it's an host specific insect. It is also called sting bug. This insect is pest to forest, trees and agriculture crops. The fruiting body sprouts out from between the insect's thorax and head, and it continue to take nutrition from the dead body. The fungi are very host specific, as I mentioned earlier. So the spore travel and infect many more sting bug. The question answer to the question is here, that why it was in the news. By understanding its significance, we will come to know that it's a very beneficial to us. So first, see the significance. The sting bug is known to damage the flower and fruits of soybean, green beans, एप्पल एंड पर्ल्स. सो इट हैज नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑन फ्रूट्स एंड स्टडीज हैव शोन दैट दीज फंगाई कैन बी यूज्ड एज अ बायोलॉजिकल पेस्ट कंट्रोल. करेंटली वी आर यूजिंग केमिकल पेस्ट टू कंट्रोल इंसेक्ट्स एंड इट हैज़ अ पोटेंशियल टू रिड्यूस द यूज ऑफ केमिकल्स इन आवर फील्ड विच विल बी अल्टीमेट रिड्यूस द हार्मफुल इफेक्ट ऑफ केमिकल्स टू आवर हेल्थ थ्रू द फूड. एंड द फोर्थ मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी इज दैट इट हैज़ अ मेडिसिनल प्रॉपर्टीज. Here it is not clear that what kind of medicinal property it has, but China is using it from a long time, and it's rich in biologically active metabolite vitamin C, phenolic compound, and also has an inflammatory and anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties. It also contains component called cordycepine, which has anti-cancer properties. That means it can be used to treat cancer. These three topics for today's class. Thank you. Have a good day. Best of luck.